Hello. I would like to thank the organizer for giving me the opportunity to present the NFCore community at Jobim. That's a very nice opportunity for me. And so let's begin. I'm working at the Swedish Childhood Tumor Biobank, which is located within the Karolinska Institute here in Stockholm. And I'm also sitting half-time at the National Genomic Infrastructure, which is a sequencing facility used by researchers all over Sweden. And I'm here all the time to develop pipeline, because we do need analysis pipeline also for the biobank. And we decided to be together and to share the effort in developing. NGI is part of SciLifeLab, which is a national center for molecular bioscience. And SciLifeLab is comprised of several infrastructure. And with NGI, we do also collaborate a lot with the National Bioinformatics Infrastructure Sweden, which is NBIS, which is the local Elixir node. For me, as a bioinformatician, I think that reproducibility is a central matter. And yes, and I think that's why we really started to use NextFlo. So for us at NGI, we were early adopters of NextFlo for its portability, for its shareability, and of course for the reproducibility. NextFlo is a data-driven language, which means that the way to link all the different tools within the pipeline, so the execution graph, depends on the input data and is calculated on the go. In StateMake, it's actually the other way around. The execution graph depends on the final target and is calculated before launch. And for me, that's the main difference between StateMake and NextFlo, just the logics are different. But apart from that, I do think the language do provide similar possibilities, and I'm just happy as long as you use a workflow manager. So NextFlo supports the main scheduler on regular HPCs and also on a cloud platform. For reproducibility, it supports virtual environments such as Conda and also container engines such as Docker and Singularity. Let's now talk about NFCore. So at NGI, we have been developing analysis pipeline for years, and we have been using a set of standards that helped other group run the pipeline on their own. And the pipeline began to outgrow the NGI and the SciLifeLab branding. So in late 2017, Phil Jules from NGI, Alex Pelzer and Sven Flinger from Cubic, and Andreas Wim from A*STAR decided to merge all their efforts together, and we created the NFCore organization and moved all the NGI pipeline in this new organization, and we removed all the branding and everything. And then we started working also on new pipelines. 1 year later, we were 12 institutes. Last year, we were 27 institutes. And nowadays, we are 39 institutes. So we have a website. You can use this link to have more information about how to join the community. We are active on Twitter. We also are using YouTube more and more, especially nowadays with the pandemic and the lockdown. We do have a Slack as well, and I think I might be using that a bit too much also. And of course, we have GitHub. GitHub is where we organize all our different repositories for the pipeline and for the website and the tools that we provide as well. On our website, we also list all the pipelines that we provide. So currently, we have 25 release pipelines, 14 under development. These are the pipelines that have been released most recently. So we worked on this viral recon pipeline was led by Archil Patel from the Francis Crick Institute, and it's about analyzing analyzing data from the COVID-19. This is SAREC is my own pipeline about to detect germline and somatic variant from whole genome sequencing, exome sequencing, or targeted sequencing. We also have a pipeline for mass spectrometry analysis, SLAM-seq, coupled with host identification, and also a pipeline to identify and quantify peptides from mass spectrometry data. Here are our most starred pipeline. So we have RNA-seq, ChIP-seq, MesinSeq, AmpliSeq, ATAC-seq pipeline, of course, SAREC. I like my pipeline. We also have a pipeline to detect gene fusion and a pipeline to analyze ancient DNA. For a pipeline to be able to be an NF-core pipeline, it has to be a NextFlow-based pipeline because we are strongly tied to the NextFlow community. We all choose to use NextFlow, and we want our pipeline to have the same common structure, which is based on the template that we provide. They need to have stable release tags. That helps us for reproducibility, of course. We need to have MIT license. That way, it can also be used in commercial settings. We do strongly advise the software to be bundled for reproducibility. And we do also advise to use continuous integration testing. Apart from pipelines, we do also provide a companion tool, which is called NFCore Tools, that helps with the most common tasks that we can do. So you can use it to list all the available pipelines within NFCore, run a pipeline with interactive prompts asking you about the different parameters that need to be selected. You can also download the pipeline for offline usage and then transfer the pipeline, the code, and the container on the server, which is completely cut from internet. This is our case in Sweden. We have an offline server for human data. You can also list the licenses that all the tools in the pipeline are using. And of course, and I think this is important for us, you can create a new pipeline from the template and check pipeline code against guidelines. So to create a new pipeline, it's actually quite simple. You just type NFCore create, and then you just need to type the name of the pipeline, short description of the pipeline, your author name, and this will create a skeleton, a minimal skeleton, that does provide at least, I think, one multi-QC process for reporting. And we are working to make it less specific to NFCore to also help the whole NextFlow community. Also, when we are making a pipeline, we do need to take care about software dependencies. We are quite involved within the Bioconda community, and we do maintain and add recipe from time to time. And we do advise that the way we do that in NFCore is that we install all the tools, if possible, within a single Conda environment that is actually bundled into a Docker container. So NextFlow, that way, you can download from Docker either as a singularity image or as a Docker container. And that setting allow us for an easy update of the tool because we just have to change the version number in the Conda environment file and an easy usage of all the different container engine or virtual environment that you want to use on your system. One thing that is also very important for me is the configuration. We do try to provide all pipeline with a default sensible configuration for a regular size cluster. But of course, that's you need to specify which scheduler you're using and stuff like that. So to help people from the same institute sharing pipeline, we do provide a GitHub repository that is being checked when you launch a pipeline that do allow to share configuration between pipeline for a specific HPC. So it means that if someone in an institute managed to make an NF core pipeline work by specifying the right amount of CPU time and memory requirement, the right scheduler, the queue if available or the environment, the path to the command reference file, etc., etc., etc. Anyone else from the same institute will be able to run any other NF core pipeline. So as I said earlier, we are quite involved with the Nextflow developer, and we are up to date with the latest development. At the moment, we are working on making full-size dataset testing for pipeline releases on AWS. We are also working to make a graphical user interface to launch pipelines. And with the latest version of Nextflow DSL2, we are developing modules which will allow for more modular pipelines, which will be similar to the Snake Make rule files. Let me present you the core team. So these are the people that do help in administrating the NF Core community. If you are interested and you want to join the core team, it's possible. We are open for a position. And so Johannes, Phil, and I, we are from Stockholm. Alex, Sven, and Gisela are from Germany. Archid is in the UK, and Olga is in the US. We also wrote a correspondence in Nature Biotechnology. Phil is a little bit crazy about statistics, so we have extensive statistics about anything that you would think of on the website. For example, we have a contributor leaderboard about every contribution that has been made on the master branch of all the repositories within NF Core. You also have information about the minimum response time for issues or pull requests, and so on. Of course, we're a community, so we do also some events. That was the last hackathon that we made in London at the Quick Institute. That was just before the pandemic. We were planning to do one hackathon in Germany quite soon, and it will still happen, but it will be a virtual one. It's still open, so if you want to register to it, feel free to it. There will be some tutorial to help you make your own pipeline, to help you collaborate and on the pipeline, and also to help you use pipeline and such. And we will also try to work on other core features that we want to be implemented. So as a stay-at-home message, I just want to recapitulate what I said. So we do provide a pipeline with good reporting for facilities, with validated release so that we have reproducibility. For the user, we have portable and easy-to-use pipelines that are well-documented. They are easy to share between different collaborators. And for the developer, we do provide templates and tools to help you simplify the command task. I would thank the organizer for giving me the opportunity to talk at this session. I would like to thank all the institute I'm working with or at. I would like to thank all the institute within the NF Core community. I would like also to thank all the contributors for the NF Core project. And of course, I would like to thank all of you for listening to this talk. If you have any question, please feel free to ask.
Bon. Merci beaucoup, Maxime. So there is two questions on the Slack, not the Slack, but the Q&A panel. But so the first one is from Gilles Le Corbillier. So do you plan to build links with the EOSClife project workflow hub that is developed by European Bioinformatic Institute, by the Carol Goebbels group, for example?
I'm afraid I'm not aware of this initiative. So I will look more, but I think we do want to collaborate with more people. The whole point of making this project was to avoid developing the same stuff on separate sites. We do want to collaborate if it's possible. So,
Gilles, tu veux peut-être préciser les choses? Okay.
No, it's okay. So it's a registry. It's not something to. And it's agnostic, so yes, they will propose some SnakeMake, some Nextflow, some CWL and Galaxy Workflow. So it's not duplicate effort, but
yes,
maybe
no,
you can join it. So it's workflowhub.eu.
Okay, no, but then I will look more. I am pretty sure some other people within NFCore are aware of that, but yes.
Okay. Donc on a une seconde question. De how you test the reproducibility of your pipeline to ensure their work in new platform?
So for us at the moment, what we are doing, we do provide containers that contain the same version number and that are tagged for a specific version. And if you use that, you should be able to have the same reproducibility. Nextflow, I think if I remember well the paper, they did try that and they proved that it was reproducible. So for us, that's enough. That's what we plan to do with being able to make the life size test within AWS. And I think at some point also I would like that we could be able to develop some more tests. At the moment we are just doing some continuous integration testing, but I would love to make some validation testing if it's possible using a golden set of data tests or stuff like that. But it's kind of difficult because we do provide pipeline for different kind of data. So I think it's something that needs to be done on a pipeline basis.